Well, it is a small world. It's been a while, hasn't it? Mind if I sit with you? I have to say, it's a pleasure seeing you again. You look well. Yes, sometimes I take the bus too. Even I. Where are you headed? The night is young. Turn in early. Ah, sensible. Myself? Oh, a late night grocery run. Yes, I'm afraid I presently find myself short on a few odds and ends. Nosy, aren't we? Relax, I only jest. If you must know, I happen to be somewhat hungry. I... You're wearing the amulet, aren't you? Ah, there it is. Concealed. Clever. You know, I should thank you for heeding me. I was right. You most certainly are a very good listener. What am I really doing? I think you're a smart one. I think you can guess. I think you've always known. You never needed the amulet around me, correct? I require sustenance of a most particular sort. But I am to be a part of this human world, not apart from it. That requires finesse. I may cause ripples upon the surface of these waters, but I shall never break it. Therein lies peril, and not just upon mine own head. Blood, sweetness. Human blood. Once a week, every week, I seek blood. I need it. Without it, I shall wither. I'll be honest, once upon a midnight dreary, I lived for the hunt. Long time ago. It was indescribable. But I've learned the hard way. There are few left like me. I am alone and humbled. But humans, you blossomed. No hunter am I, no. Antiquated notion. Deadly notion. Not even your equal. I'm diminished. Tell me, sweetness, what is my place in your world? After all this time, I cannot find the answer. Do you know? This is not my world. Be I a leech? Might I rebalance your humours, perchance? Speechless. No, I didn't expect you to. But a tiny cog in a great machine might still know a little of the machine's function, at least a little better than the rats. I'm a servant. That is, The best answer I can divine. Humanity is my charge. That is mine bloody purpose. I take supper to prolong my existence, but payment in blood incurs a heavy debt. Have I lost you? I apologize. My thoughts are disorganized. The only grey matter you'll find up here are the cobwebs. I'm saying that I need be selective. I only feed from those who can afford to lose a little blood. Oh, I mean, can afford it morally. And at this hour, in this part of town, you meet all sorts of people. I don't believe in fate, so I make my own. No. If I must take for my own sake, then I'd better choose my donors wisely. I could have taken you the second you entered my home, but it was an honest mistake, wasn't it? Would you deserve that? Yes, I'd say some people do. Who should decide? Well, why not me? No, I don't kill. Not often. I erase their memories of me, but leave enough for the experience to be a lesson. I get a meal. They get the opportunity to do better. Everyone wins. It's not bad as rationalizations go, is it? I try to avoid regulars. If a lesson doesn't stick... Oh, you mean... Beings as old as I don't typically have the luxury of friends. As I age and they don't, jokes become questions, become concerns, become suspicion. To whom would you have me turn? I'm sorry. You don't know what you're asking for. You... You're right. I didn't mean to condescend. I'm saying you should not make that offer lightly. Do you fully understand the gravity of what you just said? Or was that a fleeting whim? No, sweetness, I'm not turning you down. I'm just not sure you have the wherewithal to offer in the first place. Have you been drinking? Oh, yes, it does flavor the blood, but that's beside the point. Maybe engaging with you was a mistake. I'm not going to see you harmed just because you're feeling reckless. All right, look me in the eye. Look me in... No, you don't understand. You think you do, but... You are curious. Curious. I may not be much of a fanatic for modern idioms, but a particularly cautionary one leaps somewhat readily to mind. No, stop. Why are you so insistent? I don't understand. Oh. You owe me nothing. What makes you think that? If anything... A gift. I cannot. It is too much to offer. Yes. Yes, the amulet is of some value. I gave it to you because I have no need of it. All right, all right. If you insist, then I accept. Just a taste. It will save me from finding a source tonight. Yes, a bus stop is fine. We are alone with the moon, and by my glamour, no passers-by shall see. Now, give me your hand. Thank you. Ah, you are warm. Here. By my heart. No, it doesn't beat. Yours, however. Relax. If you require me to stop, just push with your hand. All right. Ready? May I? Very well. I shall. Expose your neck a little. There. Okay. Relax your muscles. Clear your mind. This will feel uncomfortable. There will be a dull spark of pain, but it will be fleeting. It will feel like I am taking more than I shall. A slower feeding is gentler. I'm going to begin. Don't tense up. Keep loose. All right. Relax yourself. You well? Good. Yes, yes, I'm done. No, don't move. We don't want you to get lightheaded. Hold on. The bleeding has stopped. No need for bandages. It heals fast. Thank you. You have permitted me a great boon this night. I am honored. Come, let us get you home. No, the bus isn't here yet, but I can take us there faster. I usually limit myself to human methods. It grounds me, reminds me of my place. But I think for tonight, we can allow ourselves to cheat. Arm over my shoulder. Like that. And slowly to your feet. There you are. Now, which way? Understood. All right, sweetness. Stand close and hold tight. And you may wish to close your eyes. I'll take you to your door. You removed your welcome mat, didn't you?